Hello, welcome to our OpenManage Integration for VMware vCenter training series. This video will walk you through the firmware update process. To update firmware using OpenManage Integration for VMware vCenter, we must go to the vCenter and launch the OpenManage Integration plugin. The firmware update feature is found on the Compliance and Deployment tab. Here we can see the repository profile. It comes default configured for the Dell online catalog. If you want to change to another online catalog, you can edit the profile here to do a custom online profile. There is no other way to add a custom online profile to OpenManage Integration for VMware. Once we have a repository profile, we need to create a cluster profile for the VMware vCenter cluster in our data center. Here I'm choosing the online catalog as the default source. And I'm going to select our vCenter servers in the Sysman cluster. You can choose the drift detection. We'll set this once a week as default selection and finish through the wizard. Once we create the catalog and it has had a chance to run the initial drift report, we can check the configuration compliance here and seeing that our cluster is not compliant. We can also view that report to see what firmware is available for our cluster. To remediate the cluster, we have to navigate back to the host and clusters, select our cluster, and then from the actions dropdown, there's an OMIVV cluster action where we can choose to update the firmware. As we step through the wizard, we can see the default Dell catalog is selected here, as well as what identified bundles in the repository we're going to be checking against. Here is a list of our cluster objects along with the firmware updates. We can select any firmware updates that we want to apply and then simply finish the wizard to apply the updates. Once the updates are complete, you can go to the OpenManage integration to check and make sure that the updates were applied successfully. Again, we have to update our drift report. Here under drift detection in the jobs is the current drift report. We simply run this now to see any changes with the firmware update. Some common troubleshooting for OMIVV firmware would be if the wizard does not show any valid firmware updates, check the host inventory to make sure that it knows the current firmware revisions. Also check the repository profile being used and ensure it has newer updates. Remember, IDRACs only accept .exe format, so DRM offline shares with .bin files will show in this fashion as well. If the firmware update job fails, unable to download the updates, check the details of the job or the logs to find out where it's failing. If it fails to connect to downloads.dell.com or download all updates, verify that the network can reach downloads.dell.com/catalog and download the catalog.xml.gz file. Since this operates over port 443, if they are using a proxy in the network, they may be blocking at the URL level. If the firmware update job fails where it's unable to push the update to the iDRAC, check the details of the job or logs and find out where it's failing. If the update just fails to be pushed to the iDRAC, check the iDRAC for error message in the LCC log. If the update does successfully copy but fails to be applied to the iDRAC, troubleshoot the iDRAC and lifecycle controller normally. Thank you for watching.